called Becoming a Cliche. It was last week, sitting there using my computer, and I don't know about you, but my computer is like my life. I hate to say that, but come every way for me to communicate out, every way for people to get in touch with me, whether it's taking pictures of my birds or listening to whatever, it's everything. And I'm sitting there not bothering anybody. It goes blue, it freezes. A message comes up that says, we've detected suspicious activities. Don't turn off your computer. Phone this number. I phoned the number. Like, I would do anything. Let's face it. I phoned the number, and this nice fellow comes on, a young fellow, fairly heavy accent. He says, well, may I help you? And I said, I hope so. This has just happened. It's frozen. I don't know what to do. He said, well, we can help you. Do I have your name? Give him the name. He said, now what device are you using? I tell him. And do you have other devices? No. So we go ahead with this. He go ahead. And I'm so happy because any question he can ask me, I've got the answer. You know, what are my banks? Do I have Visa? What is that and everything? And I'm thinking, well, I want to answer this question right. And so I answer it and I answer it. And he says, if you'll just hold for a little while, I'll get back to you, and we can find out what's happening with this and fix it. I say, well, what if you go off the line? What'll I do then? He said, no, ma'am, don't worry. This is my direct line. You can call me if anything happens. Then he comes back a while later. I can't give you the exact time sequence. And he says, we have discovered, madam, that at 7:34 and 7:38 this morning, somebody charged to your Visa porn from Pornhub. And it was child porn. But can there be anything worse? And so I said, what do we do about it? And he said, now, ma'am, don't worry. I'll be talking with someone, and we will find out what happened, why, and what can be corrected. And then he says, the want the money. And if we do a certain thing, do you know what duplicate billing is? I say, no, I don't. He said, well, with duplicate billing, we can sort of pay this, then it gets all erased when they have the money via, and then how does that money get to them? He said, well, you go to the bank and you get the money from the bank, but don't tell anyone at the bank why you're getting this, because if it's an inside job, it'll tip them off and the whole thing will fall apart. And then, when you have the money, you will call me outside the bank, and then I will call you, and I will tell you where you go then in order to pay with that crypto coin I was just explaining to you about. And I went to the bank. I went to the bank of Van City. I go to them, and I say, I want this amount of money, which was virtually all my savings, if you don't mind me saying it. He said, I can't do that. I said, what do you mean? He said, well, we can't do that much cash. I said, you're a bank. Don't you have it sitting there in the back somewhere? What is this, you know? And so he says, no, we have limits per day, and we can't do this. He said, perhaps you'd like to talk with the manager. And I said, yeah, I definitely do want to talk with the manager. So I walk over to the manager. What was her name? She asked me a couple of questions. I decided by then that I would say why, because even no matter what, I know there's a limit how stupid you can look at just saying, I want this money and all that. And so I said, you know, I'm trying to get this computer released, and I explained a bit to her, and she says, this is a scam. This is a scam. And I'm going like, you know, finally. She said, but don't feel stupid or anything about that. There's no reason to. This happens everywhere, and they are enormously skilled. You know, it's not like you've done it. People all the time this happens to, because they're just so good at it. Because every little question I had, you know, I said at one point, you mean I'm going to walk down to some place I don't know, weigh $1,000 bills and hand it to somebody or shove it into an ATM machine? She said, man, this is the way it works. So we go ahead. So I then just spend time at that bank reversing all of any kind of transaction, changing the passwords. I go to my other bank, do the same thing, freeze the accounts, you know. And at the end of that day, I'm almost proud of myself in a weird way. You know, I'd answered all things. I had worked with these young fellows, and I'd learned more things about keys on my computer, and I congratulated them on how good they were at being patient with people who were uneasy. But the next day it hit me. Then it really did. What you'd call PTSD, bad dreams, panic attacks, and above all, feeling afraid, just feeling unsafe. Fortunately, I was that day with a friend, bird watching and all that, and we could talk about it. And she said to me, look, you were violated. You know, no wonder you're feeling the panic attack. It wasn't that you were stupid. You were violated, you were gullible, and they were playing into the nice parts of you that you like to encourage workers that are being exploited in call centers somewhere, that they're doing a good job. Naturally, that is what you feel. And so it's not over yet, but one of the things I learned is what helps is indeed talking. That I've not so much become a cliche as I've become a story to myself. And I'm telling you this story now, and you're listening to it. And we're all in it together, and I thank you so much.
You're wonderful. What a difference in your day. Seems as though your troubles disappear like a feather in your